You're in a conversation and someone says, I don't like any of the candidates, so I'm not voting. What would you say? Sometimes choices in elections are difficult. In an ideal world, we would always have the chance to vote for a really great person that we agree with in every way. But sometimes we don't have that option. But that doesn't mean we should throw away our ballots, and here are three reasons why. Number one, a vote doesn't always mean I think they're great. It may just mean I think they're better. On social media, we like posts as a way of showing our approval. And in some ways, a vote feels the same. So we may hesitate to vote if it feels like we can't like the candidates or approve of everything they say and do. But voting may be less similar to liking an Instagram post and more like hiring someone for a job. You may not have the ideal candidate, but the job still has to be filled. And looking through the resumes and listening to the applicants, you may conclude that one person would do the job better than the others, even if none of them were exactly what you were looking for. You may even decide to hire the person who will do the least damage. In the same way, our ballot may not always give us choices that we like, but that doesn't mean there aren't ways to choose between imperfect options. And that leads to our second point. Number two, vote for the best policies. Character always matters. But if the options don't include a person we can enthusiastically support, maybe they represent policies that we can enthusiastically support. Is one candidate working on behalf of the abortion industry while the other works to defend life? Does one candidate defend conscience rights while the other supports suing nuns and churches that live out their faith? Does one candidate want parents involved in their child's education and healthcare decisions while the other wants the state to interfere with parental rights? Every voter must work out which issues matter most. But in a situation where all the candidates are flawed, we may be able to gain clarity about who to vote for based on the policies they endorse. Which leads to the third point. Number three, vote for the best team. No politician works alone. Most candidates are part of a political party, and all candidates have donors and supporters. Executive offices like mayors, governors, and presidents also appoint cabinet members, judges, ambassadors, and thousands of other positions that affect how government operates. In choosing one candidate over another, it's important to think about the team that each brings along with them. If neither coach is ideal, which direction is the team going? Voting isn't always easy. As in all of life, we're often presented with imperfect choices, but that doesn't mean we shouldn't be involved. So next time someone tells you it's best not to vote if you don't like either candidate, remember these three things. Number one, a vote doesn't always mean I think they're great. It may just mean I think they're better. And number two, vote for the best policies. And number three, vote for the best team. For What Would You Say? I'm Joseph Backholm.